During a time when Africa has lost its direction, after centuries of European and Arab occupation, and now suffers under neo-colonialism and corrupt leaders, Ma'at offers clear solutions. In an Africa where a few people have everything, and the majority have nothing, and ethnic conflicts constantly divide communities, African thought remains relevant and effective for today's challenges. The solutions to Africa's problems can be found within Africa itself. Africans need to recognize that as the first children of God and the civilizers of humanity, they have an important mission and role to play on the global stage. This mission is to sustain life, which is a beautiful and noble goal. Ma'at is the traditional African way of thinking, known by different names among black communities. With the rise of Afrocentrism, many people have heard of Ma'at. But what exactly is Ma'at? How do we understand it? What does it teach? How do we apply it to our lives? Let's explore the basics of African philosophy. To grasp what will be discussed here, it's essential to first understand what Ma'at truly is. Ma'at is the set of laws that guided the lives of ancient Kamites, that is, black Africans. After studying the universe and discovering God, our ancestors concluded that the purpose of life was to preserve and perpetuate it. They created laws to ensure order and harmony in society. Just as God brought order from the chaos of the primordial waters, also known as Nun. Every human being, like God at the beginning, must replace disorder with order, evil with good, lies with truth and injustice with justice to ensure life continues. Ma'at embodies this concept of sustaining life through truth and righteousness. Isfet is the opposite of Ma'at and represents chaos and evil. Isfet and its followers must be defeated, even by force, if necessary. This dedication to good explains why ancient Africans were considered one of the most virtuous peoples. They had little to no famine, no homelessness, strong solidarity, fewer and less bloody wars, beloved kings who ruled for the people's good, and hospitality towards foreigners. Historian Louise Marie Diop-Mice described ancient African society as astonishingly human. Ma'at is found throughout Africa under various names, such as Mbog among the Bassa of Cameroon, Mbongi in Congo and Angola, Mbok among the Wolof in Senegal, and many others. All these names all reflect the same concept of order and harmony. Every African's life must be dedicated to practicing Ma'at. At death, the body perishes, but the indestructible energy gains eternal life. The spirit or soul is judged by Osiris, during the Last Judgment. Usir, the first being to experience the cycle of life, death, justification, and resurrection, presides over the tribunal, accompanied by his sister wife Isata, Isis, and their sister Nabintu, Nephthys. He determines who has obeyed the divine laws. Understanding and living by Ma'at ensures order, harmony, and the continuation of life, both in this world and the next. The Book of Effective Formulas for Fusion in the Divine Light, commonly known as the Book of the Dead, shows the deceased and his wife, dressed in white, undergoing the test of divine judgment. At the top of the image, you can see some of the 42 gods of Ma'at. Inpu, also known as Anubis. With the head of a dog, he is in charge of the scales, balancing Ma'at's feather on one side and the heart of the deceased on the other. Jehauti, also known as Thoth. With the head of an ibis, he records the judgment. Amaut, a creature with parts of a crocodile, leopard, and hippopotamus. The deceased is led into the hall of the two Ma'at by Horus. Inpu, Anubis, places the heart of the deceased, which holds the Ba, soul, on one side of the scale. The heart must be as light as Ma'at's feather on the other side. Jehuti, Thoth, writes down the outcome of the judgment. The heart must be light, indicating that the deceased followed the 42 commandments. If the judgment is positive, the deceased is justified by Usir, Osiris, and his soul is reincarnated in a newborn. The living can connect with God through this eternal energy, making the deceased a revered ancestor. If the judgment is negative, Amaut devours the heart, which then serves as food for the 42 gods of Ma'at. This scene illustrates the ancient Egyptian belief in the afterlife and the importance of living a virtuous life according to Ma'at. Usire, Osiris, was the first being to experience birth, death, justification, and resurrection. He sits on his throne, leading the tribunal of the dead, where he judges the deceased. The Book of the Dead is a collection of ancient Egyptian texts and spells meant to help a person navigate the underworld and reach the afterlife. These spells were essential because without them, it was believed a person couldn't proceed. One important spell is called the 42 Declarations of Purity, or the Negative Confessions. In this spell, the deceased confessed to sins they believed they had committed in life, as writing down crimes against Ma'at made it easier for them to be forgiven. In the Hall of Ma'at, the judgment of the dead took place, with Ma'at playing a crucial role. This ceremony, called the Judgment of Osiris, was named after Osiris, the god of the dead. During this judgment, the dead person's heart was weighed against the feather of Ma'at. If the scales balanced, it meant the deceased was worthy to meet Osiris in paradise, indicating their heart was free from sin and evil. If the heart was heavier than the feather, it would be devoured by Amit, a soul-eating monster with the head of a crocodile, the forequarters of a lion, and the hindquarters of a hippopotamus. Other gods in the judgment hall, who were part of the tribunal, also held a feather, but the scales always represented Ma'at. Listen carefully to the 42 negative confessions. I have not committed iniquity against men. I didn't mistreat people. I have not committed sins in the place of truth. I have not sought to know what is not to be known. I have not meddled in other people's affairs. I didn't hurt. I did not start my day of work by receiving a commission from the people who were to work under my eye. I was not corrupted. My name did not reach the duties of a worker's leader. I have not deprived a craftsman of his possessions. I have not done what is abominable to the gods. I didn't make people cry. I didn't kill. I didn't order to kill. I didn't hurt anyone. I have not diminished the food offerings in the temples. I have not blasphemed the primordial gods. I have not stolen the cakes of the blessed. I have not been a pederast. I didn't fornicate, sex with a married person. I did not cut off by the bushel, stole wheat. I have not falsified accounts. I didn't cheat on the pitch. I didn't add to the weight of the scale. I didn't bend the scales. I have not taken the milk from the mouths of little children. I have not deprived the small cattle of their pastures. I have not trapped birds in the reed beds of the gods. I have not caught fish from their lagoons. I didn't hold back water in his season. I did not oppose a dike to running water. I have not extinguished a fire in his ardor. I have not omitted the days of meat offerings. I have not turned the cattle away from the god's meal. I did not oppose a god in his processional outings. I didn't blaspheme. God, I did not act violently. I wasn't in a bad mood. I have not been deaf to the words of truth. I wasn't talkative. I didn't tell a lie. I didn't inspire any fears. I didn't pollute the waters. I did not insult the king. I wasn't haughty. Until the lions have their own historians, the tales of the hunt will always glorify the hunter.